Le Morte d'Arthur by Thomas Malory. Book 1, Chapter 4. Of the Death of King Uther Pendragon. Then, within 2 years, King Uther fell sick of a great malady. And in the meanwhile, his enemies usurped upon him, and did a great battle upon his men, and slew many of his people. "Sir," said Merlin, "ye may not lie so as ye do, for ye must to the field, though ye ride on a horse litter. For ye shall never have the better of your enemies, but if your person be there, and then shall ye have the victory." So it was done, as Merlin had devised, and they carried the king forth in a horse litter, with a great host, towards his enemies. And at St. Albans there met with the king a great host of the north. And that day Sir Ulfius and Sir Brastias did great deeds of arms, and King Uther's men overcame the northern battle, and slew many people, and put the remnant to flight. And then the king returned unto London, and made great joy of his victory. And then he fell passing sore sick, so that 3 days and 3 nights he was speechless. Wherefore all the barons made great sorrow, and asked Merlin what counsel were best. "There is none other remedy," said Merlin, "but God will have his will. But look ye, all barons be before King Uther to morn, and God and I shall make him to speak." So on the morn all the barons with Merlin came tofore the king. Then Merlin said aloud unto King Uther, "Sir, shall your son Arthur be king after your days, of this realm, with all the appurtenance?" Then Uther Pendragon turned to him, and said in hearing of all of them, "I give him God's blessing and mine, and bid him pray for my soul, and righteously and worshipfully that he claim the crown upon forfeiture of my blessing." And therewith he yielded up the ghost. And then he was interred, as longed to a king. Wherefore the queen, Fairy Grania, made great sorrow, and all the barons.